Hi friends, this is Manish Khanna. Today I'm going to be showing you how to make an edible chocolate fabric. It is very easy to make and it is very versatile in its use. You can print it with a stencil on top with in different patterns and use it to make pleats on your cake. You can even use it to represent a sari on your cake if you're doing an Indian inspired cake. It's very easy, very simple, and can add a lot of wonders to your cake. So let's get started. For the printed chocolate edible fabric, we will be using water, gelatin. I have chocolate here. Chocolate, you can use either the couverture or the compound, either works. We have some vanilla essence. And we have some glycerin. Then I have some golden luster dust, which we will use to make the design of the sari on top. The chocolate that I have, I will take this into the microwave and I will melt this. To the glycerin, I will add the water. I will leave it aside to bloom, after which I will just microwave it slightly till it is processed. This chocolate, I have melted in the microwave, and as you can see, it doesn't have any lumps and it's quite smooth. Now to this, I will be adding the gelatin which I have processed and just mix that out. To this, we will add the vanilla essence and the glycerin. Yeah, once I've done this, I will mix this thoroughly so that it's a smooth mixture and it doesn't have any lumps. Also be careful, do not use a whisk for this, because if you use a whisk, you will be incorporating air bubbles into this, and then when you make the fabric will have small bubbles inside. So as you can see now, it has been mixed properly. Now we will move on to the next step. This batter I will take and I will pour it on a silicone mat. On the silicone mat, I will use a palette knife and I will spread it into a thin layer. I have spread it thinly onto the silicone mat. Now this silicone mat, I will put it into the fridge for it to set, so that it will be easier to handle and make our patterns on the fabric once it's set. So this will go into the fridge for about 8 to 10 minutes. Now I have removed this from the fridge and as you can see, it is set. I will gently just peel this off, and as you can see, our fabric is ready. Now to this, we will be doing a little stencil with the gold and a stencil to give it a look of a sari. Now normally when we are spreading this out, we don't get the edges proper, right? So what we'll do is, using a scissors, we will cut this out and make it into a proper rectangle. I have cut the fabric into a proper rectangle and I have kept it on a silicone mat. Next, I have taken the luster powder and I have mixed it with vodka. If you don't want to use alcohol, you can use the non-alcoholic Evaporex, which is available. On this, I'm just taking a stencil. I will keep it gently on top and just press it slightly so that it sticks to the fabric. Next, I will take this and, without taking too much, just spread it so that we get that pattern on the fabric. Otherwise, it will spread out and not give you the pattern that you are looking for. Round. Now I'm going to leave it for about 15 minutes so that the alcohol will evaporate, and then I will pull out the sheet so that it doesn't get damaged. The pattern stays intact. Now it has been drying out for about 10 minutes. So very gently I will pull out the mold. And as you can see, we have a golden and black edible printed sari to decorate our cake ready. सब्सक्राइब कीजिए हमारे चैनल को और प्रेस कीजिए बेल आइकन ताकि हम लाते रहें आपके लिए सिंपल बेकिंग रेसिपीज़।